I'm first to express my thanks to you for being here today at this side event, which is a follow-up, actually, to the Greek proposal about the protection of cultural and natural heritage from the climate change impacts presented at the Climate Change Summit in New York in September 2019. This event attempts to foster discussion on the new challenges that climate change poses to our cultural and natural heritage and to highlight the need for accelerated action. Museums, archaeological sites, and historical buildings are rarely included in the conversations about climate change, which tend to focus on the wider impact and global threats to our contemporary world. Yet, these threats impact everything from local cultural practices to iconic sites of outstanding universal value. In light of this, it is worth exploring the relationship between our heritage and the changing global climate in more detail. Powerful storms, desertification, and other climate phenomena are already destroying important sites at an alarming rate. Cultural heritage is considered by many as one of the four pillars of sustainable development. This is because heritage, if properly managed, can be instrumental in developing intercultural dialogue, shaping the identity of a territory, improving the quality of environment, providing social cohesion, and on the economic side, stimulating tourism development, creating jobs, and enhancing investment. In other words, investment in cultural heritage can generate return in a form of social benefits and economic growth. The impact of climate change on natural heritage, although more extensively documented, of course, requires much more urgent action than is currently taken. We are in danger of entering a vicious cycle. Climate change affects biodiversity and in turn reduces the positive effect of biodiversity on climate change mitigation and adaptation. The diversity of species and habitats is one of the foundations of life on Earth, and we must make every effort possible for the conservation and sustainable use of our natural heritage. The Greek government convened last June an international scientific conference titled Climate Change Impacts on Cultural Heritage, Facing the Challenge, with the participation of world-renowned scientists from over 43 countries. The result of this conference was a proposal with the support of the World Meteorological Organization and UNESCO, and we have to thank both of you, which the Greek Prime Minister Kyriakos Mitsotakis presented at the September UN Climate Summit. We are proud of the fact that this proposal has been supported by more than 60 countries up to now, ladies and gentlemen, and we hope that this number will increase significantly. Within this context, in 2020, we are convening in Athens a meeting of heads of states, governments, and international organizations to present the overview of the joint proposal. The outcome of the collaboration will utilize the expertise of UNESCO on cultural heritage and of the WMO on all important meteorological and hydrological events. Mr. Zerefos, the very well-known Greek professor, which has been nominated as the representative of Greece as regards climate change, will refer to a specific idea later on regarding creating an intergovernmental panel for climate change and cultural heritage. Finally, I would like to express my appreciation for your presence today and invite you to offer your support to the Greek initiative, which views the effects of climate change through the lens of cultural and natural heritage. It is our duty to make every effort to protect these invaluable assets we inherited from our ancestors and to guarantee that we will give them to the next generations in the best possible condition. Our cultural and natural heritage represent the history that has shaped our civilization, but also serves as a guiding light towards our future. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, thank you for being here, participating in this event, and supporting this initiative of Greece. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr.